Time for an update on the H1N1 flu pandemic in Central Oregon. What are we seeing locally right now? I'm Dave Adams. First, let's talk with Alan Ertl, the Senior Vice President for Medical Affairs for Cascade Healthcare Community. Tell us what your experience is with the H1N1 virus. We seem to be seeing a spike.
Right now, we've been running between 30 and 40 inpatients at any given time across the hospital system of people with influenza-like illness. And we've been running 5 or 6 people in the ICU with influenza-like illness. Of course, not all of those have H1N1, but we feel that probably a majority of them do have H1N1. I mean, there are other viruses going around, of course. So,
do you see this kind of come in waves?
Well, clearly it's been accelerating over the fall. And if you look back to, say, September 5th, right around Labor Day, it was kind of the nadir of the summer across Oregon. And it's increased since then very dramatically, and it accelerated in the early part of October. What we expect is that we're going to stay at a very high level for a period of time, and there will be little kind of mini waves of activity over the next probably 2, 3, or 4 weeks.
Is that causing you some trouble?
We were very nervous about it last Thursday because we had a lot of inpatients. Our ICUs were full, not just from H1N1, but just from all the other business that we do. And we were stretched, but we all pulled together and rallied around it, and things have quieted down a little bit.
What's your advice to people?
The county health department has a lot of good information about that. Most people aren't at high risk of complications, should stay home, take the normal things that you would for the flu, which is plenty of fluids, rest, and Tylenol or ibuprofen. If you have underlying medical problems that might put you at higher risk of complications, you certainly need to talk to your physician on the phone.
What are the trigger points for 2 different categories? For the young kids, so for parents taking care of small children, maybe babies, infants, and then for the adults, what should we watch for?
Again, I think it in babies it's a little bit different, particularly if they're very young. You know, often babies will become lethargic before you really see other signs of distress. So if you're concerned, you really need to talk to your doctor. You should have a lower threshold for talking to your doctor, particularly for very, very young children. For adults, it's really, are you having symptoms of respiratory distress? Are you feeling short of breath? Those types of things really should trigger you to either talk to your doctor on the phone or be seen.
And now let's talk to Dr. Sean Rogers, who is the medical director for Bend Memorial Clinic.
We've seen definitely an uptick in activity over the last few weeks. However, it appears to have peaked as we're seeing a number of fewer cases per day for the last several days.
Are you having a challenge with people who are not experiencing complications that are coming in and possibly infecting other people?
That's always a concern in these types of situations. However, I think with the help of the Deschutes County Health Department, I think the word has been getting out pretty good that as long as you're not terribly ill, to just wait it out and, you know, try not to go out into public places and infect other people. So, we always see some of that to some degree, but I think most people have been pretty good.
You're seeing a kind of a crest in the wave, you think?
Yes.
Fewer people? I noticed looking here on your chart that you have on your website, Monday this week kind of a peak for you.
Yeah, I mean, we're still seeing some peaks and valleys, but overall it's the trend is certainly stabilizing. It's not continuing to increase. And if you look at the number of cases throughout the county, the trend seems to be an overall gradual decline.
What kind of symptoms, or what are they coming in for your facility for?
Flu symptoms for this are pretty typical of the usual flu, high fevers, body aches, cough, sore throat. Some people are also having GI symptoms with vomiting and diarrhea.
Your advice to anybody with the flu is what?
For most people, the flu will pass uneventfully after a few days. And so we're advising them to stay home, don't go to work, be sure and drink plenty of fluids so they don't get dehydrated, take Tylenol for any aches, pains, or fevers, that type of thing. However, if they do have other serious health conditions, such as immunocompromise, they have lung problems or uncontrolled diabetes, etc., then it may be worth getting in to see the doctor to make sure that they're not developing more serious complications.
A Wednesday update on the H1N1 flu pandemic in Central Oregon. We will continue to monitor this story for you. I'm Dave Adams. Take 5 is a production of 1110 KBND Radio News. Depend on us.